Jesus said that from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. That is why a man must leave father and mother, and the two become one body. They are no longer two, therefore, but one body. So that what God has joined, man must not divide. And this is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I just wonder how many of you are married for years, you still open the door of the car for your wife when she gets in or gets out. I wonder if you all still do that. Well, they say if you see a couple that is married for years and the husband still opens the door for his wife when she gets out of the car or gets in the car. It is, the reason for it is either they are just married or it's a brand new car. Well, Mark and Jacqueline, I hope Mark will always open the door of the car for you. Even after 5, 10, 15, or 20 years, right? Today we are celebrating a very happy occasion. It is a very special day for Mark and Jacqueline. Special readings that we have chosen especially for this occasion are indeed inspiring. The first reading speaks about these wonderful qualities of a good wife. And I'm sure Jacqueline has all of them, all aspiring to be just as what the first reading describes, a model wife. You know, Mark and Jacqueline, we're not married the most perfect person, you know. Jacqueline is not the most perfect wife, nor will Mark be the most perfect wife. Very often when you get in a marriage, you think, well, I found the most perfect one on earth, the one who's going to spend the rest of my life with me. That is good on the first day of your marriage, or just before you get married. But as you go on in life, you realize, well, you did not marry an actress, but you married someone who is down to earth. And what is the purpose of marriage? It is to help each other to grow. You will discover this day that you have a very special occasion. You know, today's second reading is so inspiring. The letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. The true meaning and description of love. It is patient. It is kind. It is never boastful. And that is what your vocation would be in marriage. To shield, to support, to love, and help each other. There will always be shortcomings and failures. But it is, what is the true meaning of love? Is when we are able to make those sacrifices, to make those compromises, to help each other to be a better person, a better Christian, a better wife, a better husband, a better father. You are called in a very, very special way to be the reflection of God's love. That is what married life is all about. The love between both of you, the way you live out your life, you will be the example, the expression of God's love. Your friends, your family, your relatives, and God bless you with wonderful children in the future. You will be that wonderful example of God's love. I'm very happy you need to be here today. You know, when I came to this parish, Jacqueline was only 10 years old. And 14 years ago, I looked at the back baptism certificate of Mark. I baptized him 14 years ago. I feel like a grandfather now. You know, when I was there, I was like a father, strict and firm. But when you grow old, you become like a grandfather, you become rather indulgent. And so when both of them came to see me, to ask me would I solemnize their marriage, well, indeed, I was very, very happy to be invited to come for this marriage because, as I said, I've seen Jacqueline at the age of 10 when I came, and she was so involved in the choir, a very gentle, quiet, unassuming person, and I really feel that way. She's always been like that, and she's been a wonderful person. Mark also I've seen grow, although there's been a bit of turbulence now and then. But you know, like on the aircraft, well, there's time when it becomes turbulent, but then once you put on your seatbelt, you remain calm, the plane lands safely, you know. That is what has happened, you know. So, as I say, well, that is life. And then you become like a grandfather, you look at all this and you say, well, it's so wonderful to see all these young people now grow up. And they will start their own families. And so today, Jacqueline and Mark, you have a wonderful vocation. A vocation to be true Christians, to be the example of Christ's love in the world, your friends, your family, and so on. And remember today, you have one very important person here who is present at your wedding. You know who? The most important VIP guest you have here is Jesus. He is the most important guest. He is right now present. He is going to be in your home, in your life. In times of trials, in times of difficulties, always turn to the Lord in prayer. He will never, never let you down. In times of joy, always celebrate God's love and presence in your life. And that is the best recipe. Always remember, God must always be the center of your life. Christ must always be in your home. And I'm sure with that, you have the best recipe for happiness. You know, we all buy lottery tickets, no? We all want to touch the lottery. But Mark and Jacqueline, you have touched the lottery. You know the winning numbers, right? You know the winning numbers and you will win that lottery. You just follow what the Lord says. So today I congratulate you, and on behalf of Father Michael Sitram also, your parish priest, I congratulate you, I pray for you, that God will continue to bless you with his choices, blessings, and give you the true peace and happiness that you seek for the rest of your lives. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.